Electric current is the flow of electrons. When we talk about electrical circuits, one frequently used term other than voltage and current is resistance. The word resistance means a force that makes a process slower. Electrical resistance also means the same thing. It reduces the number of electrons moving down the conductor. In other words, resistance is a measure of opposition to current flow in an electrical circuit. To know more about this electrical resistance, continue watching. Hi, I am Benila and you are watching The Learning Curve. Quite often, the electrical resistance is explained using a water analogy. Consider the water flowing through a pipe. The flow of water is compared to the current. Resistance refers to any obstacle that slows down the flow of water. All materials have some amount of electrical resistance. Materials like gold, silver, copper, and aluminium have low resistance. These materials are called conductors. All our power transmission lines are made up of this conductor material. In most cases, the transmission line is made up of aluminium because it is lightweight and economical. Imagine having gold transmission lines. We may need a special police force just to take care of these transmission lines. Also, pure gold is very soft, so gold is not actually a good candidate for transmission line material. As I said earlier, these conductor materials have low resistance. Therefore, while doing our circuit analysis calculations, we neglect the resistance of the wire from our calculations. However, we cannot neglect the resistance of transmission lines while doing power loss and efficiency calculations. Why is it so? We are neglecting the resistance of conductor wire in our circuit analysis, but we are not neglecting the resistance of conductor wire in our transmission line power loss calculations. There is a very simple explanation for this. Let's look at our resistance formula. R is equal to rho L by A. Here, L represents the length. As length increases, the resistance value also increases. Our transmission lines are lengthy. Therefore, the resistance of the transmission line will be higher than the resistance of the small wires that connect the resistors and bulbs in our circuit calculations. Due to the presence of resistance, some power is dissipated as heat. Normally, resistance is portrayed as a culprit. That is because of this power loss and heat dissipation. However, resistance has its good side too. Heat dissipation is not always a bad thing. In some applications, we actually need heat dissipation. Appliances such as heaters, toasters, and hair dryers are examples where heat dissipation is important. Therefore, resistors are used here. Resistors are electrical components that have a fixed value of resistance. We also have a variable resistor where electrical resistance value can be adjusted. Now, let's talk about Ohm's law. George Simon Ohm was a German physicist and mathematician. He found that there is a direct proportionality between the voltage applied across a component and the resultant current flow. When he first published his work, no one accepted it. Later in 1850s, his work was recognized and proven. Mathematically, Ohm's law is written as V is equal to IR. Here, R is the resistance. The same formula can be rewritten to calculate the current and resistance respectively. The resistance is measured in ohms, symbolized by the Greek letter omega. The resistance value of the resistor in both AC and DC circuit is the same. The change in the current direction in the AC supply does not affect the resistor's behavior. That's all for today. Bye. See you in my next video.